It's a new dawn. It's a new dawn. It's a new day. It's a new day. It's a new dawn. It's a new dawn. It's a new day. It's a new day. It's a new dawn. It's a new dawn. It's a new day. It's a new day.
Eddie Nesta, no joke, and there's no jokes about it. Best podcast on the air, and it's a shame to live without it. Curtis Walker, slick talker, auto-tune in every week. Boss Lady, she's a vegan, so there's never any beef.
Put up the tone! Put up the tone!
Eddie Nesta, no joke, and there's no jokes about it. Best podcast on the air, and it's a shame to live without it. Curtis Walker, slick talker, auto-tune in every week. Boss Lady, she's a vegan, so there's never any beef. Talk about the world's choices with black voices, giving platforms to the people till we're all treated as equal. They have special guests, they're never second best. Here to represent, giving golden knowledge, they're the treasure chest. Good vibes and real talk about the world we're in today. They have thought-provoking topics, always have something to say. Leave an impression in your brain, making this lockdown feel sane. Join three of the best and get the most out of your day. Eddie Nesta's no joke, Eddie Nesta's no joke. Every Sunday, midday, everyone's in ship shape. Eddie Nesta's no joke, Eddie Nesta's no joke. Every Sunday, midday, everyone's in ship shape. Eddie Nesta's no joke, Eddie Nesta's no joke. Every Sunday, midday, everyone's in ship shape. Eddie Nesta's no joke, Eddie Nesta's no joke. Every Sunday, midday, everyone's in ship shape. Hashtag no jokes. Hashtag no jokes.
Hashtag no jokes with Eddie Nesta and friends. The lockdown edition.
Eddie Nesta, no joke, and there's no jokes about it. Best podcast on the air, and it's a shame to live without it. Curtis Walker, slick talker, auto-tune in every week. Boss Lady, she's a vegan, so there's never any beef. Talk about the world's choices with black voices, giving platforms to the people till we're all treated as equal. They have special guests, they're never second best. Here to represent, giving golden knowledge, they're the treasure chest. Good vibes and real talk about the world we're in today. They have thought-provoking topics, always have something to say. Leave an impression in your brain, making this lockdown feel sane. Join three of the best and get the most out of your day. Eddie Nesta's no joke, Eddie Nesta's no joke. Every Sunday, midday, everyone's in ship shape. Eddie Nesta's no joke, Eddie Nesta's no joke. Every Sunday, midday, everyone's in ship shape. Eddie Nesta's no joke, Eddie Nesta's no joke. Every Sunday, midday, everyone's in ship shape. Eddie Nesta's no joke, Eddie Nesta's no joke. Every Sunday, midday, everyone's in ship shape.
Hashtag no jokes with Eddie Nesta and friends. The lockdown edition. The lockdown
edition. Hashtag no jokes. Hashtag no jokes. Hashtag no jokes.
Lockdown edition. Lockdown edition.
It's a new dawn. It's a new dawn.
It's a new day.
It's a new dawn.
It's a new dawn.
It's a new day.
It's a new day.
It's a new dawn.
It's a new dawn.
It's a new day.
It's a new day.
Eddie Nesta, no joke, and there's no jokes about it. Best podcast on the air, and it's a shame to live without it. Curtis Walker, slick talker, auto-tune in every week. Boss Lady, she's a vegan, so there's never any beef.
Put up the tone.
Eddie Nesta, no joke, and there's no jokes about it. Best podcast on the air, and it's a shame to live without it. Curtis Walker, slick talker, auto-tune in every week. Boss Lady, she's a vegan, so there's never any beef. Talk about the world's choices with black voices, giving platforms to the people till we're all treated as equal. They have special guests, they're never second best. Here to represent, giving golden knowledge, they're the treasure chest. Good vibes and real talk about the world we're in today. They have thought-provoking topics, always have something to say. Leave an impression in your brain, making this lockdown feel sane. Join three of the best and get the most out of your day. Eddie Nesta's no joke, Eddie Nesta's no joke. Every Sunday, midday, everyone's in ship shape. Eddie Nesta's no joke, Eddie Nesta's no joke. Every Sunday, midday, everyone's in ship shape. Eddie Nesta's no joke, Eddie Nesta's no joke. Every Sunday, midday, everyone's in ship shape. Eddie Nesta's no joke, Eddie Nesta's no joke. Every Sunday, midday, everyone's in ship shape. Hashtag no jokes. Hashtag no jokes.
Hashtag no jokes with Eddie Nesta and friends. The lockdown edition.
Eddie Greetings and welcome to another hashtag no joke. Lockdown started and then so did we. We took a little break, but now we're going. I hope we can keep going for at least another 70 or so days so that I can achieve this thing that I'm trying to do with the 100 press-ups for charity. We've got a stellar cast, cast of lovies today. So goodness knows how we're going to try and do this, but I want to keep this show to an hour. That's what we started with, and it started creeping up and up and up and up. And we're going to keep it to what it's supposed to be. Thank you for all the people that supported us and continue to support us. Goodness knows we need it. Let me introduce you to the main man, the Don Dada of British comedy and worth his weight in gold. Curtis, how you doing, mate?
All right, my brother, worth my weight, yeah. Good to see you, sir. Very well.
Well, I tried to be nice to you.
I was waiting for the dig. I was actually waiting for the dig.
No. I just thought, the boss lady said to me, what did you say about being broke last week? Why do you feel that you need shut up. Leave me and my brethren alone. That's banter. So I thought I'd be nice, but you didn't receive it.
It wasn't banter, Eddie. I cried for the whole week. Hey. I don't like the way you're enjoying my brokenness. It's like you've been waiting for this day.
No, it's not. Funny enough, you know, the team that's come together to help us put this thing on are a team of people who haven't got any work, basically, and they've come forward. And I feel a little uncomfortable because I have got work. And I'm just saying, if people
you
enjoy
tell us
it,
every week, you're working.
If they can put a pound in.
You don't have to keep driving past my house shouting out you're working. Yeah, look at my car, petrol, living large, live the dream, Eddie. Enjoy yourself.
I tell you what, you could live better if you got rid of that dog, but we'll talk about that. That must be in 30, 40 pound a week. I could do that's a partner.
Man. He's a survivor, man. He goes and gets his own food. Well. He sometimes brings something back for me.
Yeah, well, okay. So listen, greetings. I'm not going to ignore the hair. What's going on with the hair, bro?
Just a moment of madness. I went round. I had went to a bubble, my safe zone, and they took me a Met Precket. And I wanted my hair, you know, when the hair is just at the side. I wanted that look for lockdown. And I was denied. But I haven't seen that look for a long time with hair just around here. And I wanted to judge that. And
be careful. Yeah, I've spent a good part of my morning, me and the kids, doing some colouring in. For Mrs. the boss lady's eyebrows, because there's no personal care allowed or anything like that. So it's a tough time, you know. Please don't make any comment of it when you see it. It's a tough thing. Look, well, we're blessed.
Our secret.
We're blessed. We've got lots of stories. We lost another great this week. 100,000 dead. They put out a video of black MPs, some of whom I didn't even realise were black, in order to get people to take the vaccine. So there's a lot to talk about. We're trying to keep it to an hour. Let me introduce, by the way, please excuse my manners. Good afternoon to everybody who's joined us across all the platforms. Let's introduce you to... a man, I call him a Bay Jacon. He's a mixture. He's a cocktail. We love him. Born 1961, so he's way older than all of us. We knew him as I think the top cop in the Bill, O'Cara, Superintendent O'Cara. But I know him as the guy who stole work from me. More recently seen in Noughts and Crosses. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to No Joke, Mr. Cyril Henry. How are you, Cyril?
I'm good, Eddie. I'm good. Good to see you, Curtis. Yeah.
Hello, Cyril. Nice. Good morning, sir. Good afternoon.
Oga.
You see, this is the way you start. You start already, Eddie. Just because, you know. And it's Nigerian. Bajarian.
Oh, no, gosh. Alison is a lady. No, let me tell you. Alison is a lady that's helped us with this. She is a Bajacan. You are a Bajarian, which is the same as the Equalities Minister, I think. And we'll talk about her later. So look, I mean, I named two of the many parts that you've done there, two seminal parts. You're a BAFTA-nominated actor. In terms of The Bill playing the top cop, and in terms of Noughts and Crosses, it felt like two kind of seminal moments, parts and moments. How did you view it when accepting the role?
Well, the bill, well, basically I had to pay bills, and so I did the bill. The bill was fantastic. I loved it. It was one of those things where, you know, actually it wasn't the first Top Cop. I always cite George Harris. George Harris played a character called Woolcott.
Yeah, but he wasn't a top cop, was he? I think he was a chief inspector.
There you go. You see, he was a chief. He was a chief, though. Yeah, but it was the real first, I think. First Top Cop. And it was
George Harris actually did a lot of first. He was the first black guy in Casualty, also.
What did your therapist say, Eddie?
Can you remember the name of that character in Casualty?
No.
It's called Cyril.
My name was Cyril.
No. George's character in Casualty was Cyril.
My name was Cyril.
It was the same character. They don't waste time changing names for black characters. It was the same character. You were both black. You were both Cyril. It made it easier for the makeup artist and the director to be able to know who you were.
You might be right on that one.
I'll tell you partly why. Is because Jeremy Brock, who co-wrote and created Casualty, was at Bristol when I was at Bristol, and we became good friends.
Okay.
We did a show which was called Breaking the Ice, and from there it went on. Anyhow, needless to say, other people played that character in Casualty. So,
were they all called Cyril?
Patrick Robinson's been on.
I know.
Patterson, Joseph, Chucky, Kwame Kwayama. All playing the same guy. All Cyril.
So there you go. Those things were seminal. In fact, I was looking at a picture of Mallory Burton. And one of my proudest moments standing next to Mallory, I mean, that was a book which, you know, I took my kids through, and it was fantastic. And I often wonder nowadays, particularly in these times, what would happen if, say, a small island started, you know, putting in the sort of systematic racism that the other way around.
But you know the answer. It's called Grenada, isn't it?
Well,
it's
called Zimbabwe, or it's called
I think we know.
Both of them. I like doing things that are, I remember turning down a role in The Bill way before we got to Okara, and I did two other roles in The Bill. One was a Rwandan refugee, and the other was a barrister, a black barrister who lost a rape case. Because of the judge who decided that he couldn't possibly have him win. And the role that I turned down was of a robber who, at the start of the thing, you see him committing this robbery and he runs off. And then for some reason, the man decides to come back to the scene of the crime and try and... And I went, it doesn't make sense to me. It doesn't make no sense to me.
But there's a saying, isn't there? A thief always returns to the scene of crime. I think
Not when there's cops in the building.
No, well, I'll give you that. Cyril, Cyril, I've only got an hour, Cyril.
Go ahead.
I warned you about this, Cyril.
You did warn me about this.
Cyril and I debate on the show when there's anything to do with Nigeria. He's very well read, and I'm very, very proud. Thank you very much for coming on. Somebody else who was actually my wife in a play. Some years back. No, you weren't my wife in a play. Although
no,
you
she
might,
has been my wife.
You might be soon, Cyril. this lady. Well, I don't know. When I saw Invictus, I was like, "Is that her? Is that her?" And it was. And then, of course, belatedly, we've seen her. Funny enough, I have to say, two fantastic backers of No Joke, Arnold. And Yvette Schilling have watched this program and say it took them a long time to get through it because apparently every time they saw a love scene, they try to emulate what they saw on the screen. So let's take a look at this lady in action.
You must excuse the disorderliness. As you know, I'm to host a ball this evening.
Yes.
I have managed to keep the details of your return quiet. But when those vulgar mamas discover that there is an eligible duke present at tonight's fete, I shall be able to keep such a secret no longer.
That is what I was hoping to discuss. I've only returned to London to deal with my late father's affairs. I'm afraid it leaves me no time to socialize. And so whilst I appreciate your most gracious invitation, Lady Danbury, I must ask you to accept my regrets.
Your regrets are denied.
Well, I suppose a brief appearance.
Excellent. You may leave that flask you carry at home. Most undignified.
Danbury makes her entry onto hashtag NoJoke. Welcome, Adjuan. How are you, Adjuan?
I was in Cavity for 3 years. I was Cyril.
you did 90 episodes, didn't you? I am Spartacus.
I am Cyril.
Listen, thanks so much for coming on here now.
Listen, I've been crying with laughter already, you three, honestly. Yeah, what are you like?
Good. It's Curtis. Well, we got 1, 2, 3, 4 ballads now, and the other one, the boss lady's a ballad as well.
I know.
So now you lot do it.
It was so weird to see you with here. Now, just talk to me about. Did it take a long time to stick it on?
Lord Jesus, I'm there. I'm there before anybody else is there. It's me and the poor, like, 20-year-old standing in the rain. I'm there before the electricians are there. What was I thinking? It takes so long to get all that hair on.
And but it would have at the time too, wouldn't it?
Yeah, but not quite as long as they have to give me, like, flange. They call flanges, which always just sounds disgusting to me. But they have to have flanges going up the. Because you know these bits up there to make real, because it's uppy doody hair, and I've got nothing to pin it to. I mean, this is quite long for me at the moment, just because of another job I'm doing, so I've got to grow it out a little bit. But it's like, yeah, I hate me as much as they hate me. You just see these poor makeup people with bags down here going, glue, get well, it next. Yeah,
you say that, look, and they've commissioned, haven't they, another series.
They're going again. They are. I can get some things fixed in the garden.
I think you can. You keep that. You can buy the park. I don't think you're fixing the garden. Now you're going to buy the park.
Come now. Oh. There he is.
Did you? I mean, look, Netflix is what it is, right? But did you expect it to get what it got, because it's just been the way that people have been talking about it. Did you expect that?
No. Okay, so it's like 82 million households watched it in the first 28 days. What is that? What even is that? 82? It's like, yeah. No, I mean, well, we finished it. We finished shooting just before the first lockdown. So it feels like it was in a parallel universe, and like the whole world is just. And then I went to Ghana, and then I came back from Ghana, and then we locked down. So I think, you know, it is what it is. The show is what it is. If you like it, that it is what it is. But I think it's partly because it happens. We can't have Christmas. It's raining. It's cold. Nobody's got any money. They can't go anywhere if they have got any. So there, it was just like, here's something completely non-COVID related. Are they going to shag? You know, it was just sort of go somewhere else with your head. And so, also, everybody can go somewhere else with their head. It's not like we just watch the white people go somewhere else with their head.
It's been really good. Because I always used to resent costume dramas because I thought they're only doing so many because they feel justified not to cast black people. And that's the, always thought, when they go mad about. But this one, wow, what a great genius casting. And I think that has helped to push it over the breaking all records for Netflix, apparently.
Yeah.
I think so too. And I mean, it, obviously, it's not a historical documentary because that will be a different show altogether. But neither is
The Crown.
Yeah. No, well, but you always used to have to wait till we got to the part where it came into the 40s or 50s, and the American GI would come over, or the jazz singer would come over, or some below servant, from.
When Queen Charlotte came to the British court. Sorry, I'm shouting. I'm so excited to see you all. It's like being French.
Oh, lockdown fever, Eddie. Lockdown fever. Hey, babe.
When Queen Charlotte came over, they complained about her ugly, thick lips and her wide nose and her mulatto appearance at the time in the 1700s. So, come on, catch up, everybody. I'm so bored. Catch up.
You say catch up, and yet we've got our modern-day Charlotte in Meghan, haven't we?
I know, but they talk about it like it never happened before, Eddie, is my point. Okay. That's what
okay.
I'm saying
okay.
about
okay. No, no, no. Okay.
We know what you're saying. Eddie has to do that because that's his nature. Just vicious and trying to buy We totally understood what you're saying. And they even run Meghan out of the country, made her have to leave because they couldn't embrace her as a woman of colour.
You know what? Charlotte brought the Christmas tree to this country. Charlotte brought the Christmas tree. So they never erase Charlotte. Every time you put your bauble on, you're saying, hello, Charlotte.
All right.
I'd like to talk about the real issue from this show. This brother who stole work from me. This brother who's stealing my work now. That could have been me. That could have been me.
Somehow, like looking in the mirror, isn't it?
Somehow, Eddie, I don't think it could have been you.
there's about
a foot and a half.
Hang on, Eddie, turn your head to the left a little bit. Take the pose, Eddie. Let me work your camera lens. Turn your head, Eddie.
I don't like the way this show's going. Can I just say that? It's not.
I don't want you three to have a loving and trying to leave me out that you've all been in the bill. I've all been in casualty. I ain't been in one of them. Me and Ishmael were in the bill. We were actually those feet you see walking at the top of the show. That was me and Ishmael back in the day. Yeah? Those boots were us.
Talking of feet, just telling this, Curtis, that Cyril and I did an advert for Nigerian Guinness. We were really, really proud. It was great fun, actually. Yeah. I got the good part, right? I got the part. And then they saw me reach up for the drink and they said no. They didn't like the look of my hands. Yeah. So they said, we can't have those hands in our thing. Nobody's going to buy the drink.
Yeah.
Why are you not surprised, Curtis?
Because they're not. I've seen your hands, but you would have been better off, I think, if you'd reached for it with your foot. And I don't think they would have noticed the difference, Eddie. They might have said, oh, that's a great pair of hands.
I really don't like the way this is going.
So, Cyril, did you have to come in and do hand modeling for it?
I had to do hand modeling, I'm sorry, but you know.
You could have helped him, Cyril, just offered him some Vaseline or something.
I would have tried, but, you know, stubborn.
Yeah, he wouldn't hear. Because if you ever see his feet, Cyril, I don't know if you have. I met up with him a couple months ago, and he came to Brixton in sandals, God knows why, with big people, and I got a chance to see his feet.
Oh, dear.
Oh, my God. And I thought I had bad feet before I saw Eddie Lester's.
There were a few things where we also did another ad, which was about a sort of boil up spaghetti thing. You remember that, Ed?
And
we did this racing commentary, and then at the end of the ad, for some reason, I think I fell asleep on his chest or something at the end of this ad after this raucous
I want racing. To see this ad.
And I remember my mum saying, "What's that about? What's that about? How can you have two friends doing?" And you know, I've never had so much fun as I've had with Eddie. And
that's let's move on, because this show's not about fun. As you know, this show, anybody who's listened to it before knows we don't do fun on here. And later on, we've got Solomon, and we're going to have Ashley Walters on soon as well. Look, seeing as we're lovies, let's start with, I suppose, the mother of all actors, really. At 96, we received the news that Cicely Tyson had passed away. Just take a listen and a look at this.
You will always be my generous baby girl, whether you like it or not.
You know, Miss Ruth was a lady, and a lady always knows when to leave.
But I gotta see him, Sheriff Young. I gotta see him.
You just gotta get back to reality.
The reality is that Westside Prep School is doing what we built it to do, Clarence.
Talk to the young.
We don't have that kind of time, Miss Jane.
What else you got, Jim?
Got the strength God gave us women to survive.
Adam, I don't want you to be any less than what you are.
Sometimes life doesn't give us any choice.
But it does. You always have a choice.
The joy of books is that you get to act it out for yourself.
Things began to happen, and people began to talk about, you know, this new actress, Cicely Tyson, and next thing I knew, I was here in front of you.
African Americans hold Cicely in such high regard. She would only do roles that served us as African Americans. She kept her way, she kept her class, she kept representing us, and she remained Cicely Tyson.
So, it'd be difficult not to pay tribute. And sometimes they're those actors, they're the ones that kind of make it massively, massively. And there's a kind of, I mean, there was a who's who. I don't know if you looked at some of those co-stars there, but you know, you could see Sammy Davis, you could see Morgan Freeman. I mean, lots and lots of things. And you just think, well, I don't know. I hope Kerry Washington said if it wasn't for her, she wouldn't be in the game. I just thought it was right as a group of lovies to pay a tribute to her.
Do you know, Cyril and I did a play in New York in 2013. We did Julius Caesar at the RSC over there. And one afternoon, I snuck into town and I saw Cicely Tyson do the stage version of The Road to the Bountiful with Cuba Gooding Jr. I went with Ivano Jeremiah and I took some photographs. So I've got photos of her on stage.
Wow.
I did the bad thing. You're not supposed to.
Yeah.
I was so like... It was like watching God or something. It just
wow.
Yeah.
You know, when people have that staying power, what you talked about, Eddie, with her not necessarily being, you know, the big, but she was just there doing the stuff at a level which was, you know, so far above. And she's one of those people with staying power who you just know and you know and you know.
Yeah, you see them.
They're in your life. I remember watching Roots all that time back, you know, and those are the people who just come to you and you go, they are there in every part of history. And I think Barack Obama said it about her. You know, she not only surpassed on screen, but off screen as well, in terms of her daily living, the way she was just an example of pure excellence, you know, pure excellence. And that's the most amazing thing about her. I remember Trip with the Band as well, and that New York trip, you know, and just stunning, stunning. You know.
What I hope is, Curtis, that in the same way that when a big music star passes away and everybody all of a sudden downloads and starts to look, I'm just hoping that we do that with her. We look at maybe films that we didn't know she was in, stuff that we didn't know she'd done and paid.
I think that happens, doesn't it? People kind of look to see more about the artist. What I want to see is the British equivalent of our journey here. And the pioneers in England that have been acting and doing it forever, I think of people like Mona Hammond, and that generation of actors and actresses who've done things, and we don't celebrate them here. Mm. I know it's almost lovely. America have that. They have that history. They have that, oh, it's Morgan Freeman in a scene with Sissy. It's that build-up. With the actors that you have on today, there's a history there that I know. For one, we need to kind of mark it. We need to celebrate it. We need to kind of champion it. Because I'm tired of looking at America all the time for these stories, which are beautiful stories. A very subtle actress, a workhorse actress who just did her job. Wasn't about the bling, wasn't about, just give me good roles to play, please. And America's journey is different than the British actresses here who have to fight, create their own kind of dramas if they want to celebrate their own skills, their talent. As Cyril was saying earlier, you're in the bill, you're playing a thief running into a house. I know things are changing. I just want us to mark our older actors and actresses that are still here before they pass, and let's celebrate them. Let's have a night of their work.
You're right, but let me just jump in here quickly and say, the last time I saw Adjoa, Curtis, is when I had the pleasure, along with Robbie G, of hosting Rudolph Walker's 80th birthday. I've got to tell you, that was a very moving night for me.
Yeah.
It was a very moving night, I think, for everybody there. You know, you knew that we would be talking about this night for a long time. The love from the stage, from the audience, it was just... So I hope you're right with Mona, with Corinne Skinner Carter.
Shouldn't we have a night like Rudolph's night every? You know, I know we're in unprecedented times at the moment, but we could celebrate somebody every month. You know, the same way that night where we celebrated Rudolph Walker's work, it was beautiful. It was a fantastic event.
It's a lot of work.
I know it's a lot of work. No more work than any show you're putting on, really, at the Hackney Empire or any venue. Telling me, it takes work, but that's not the reason not to do it.
We've had a couple awards for Mona. There was a Women of the World. We did a big award for Mona about 3 years ago, three years ago, and then RADA did an award for Mona as well because she's a RADA alumni from back in the day. Feels like we don't just need a night. We need the solid. You know,
the, moment,
the book, the thing where you go and you say to the 18-year-old, read this book,
exactly.
Go onto this website, all the gear is there, you can see all those people whose names we're forgetting.
We don't celebrate it often enough. I totally agree with you, Curtis. But actually, over the years, you look at it and you see, actually, they are there. And amongst us, they are celebrated. It does need to be pushed down to younger generations over and over again. But actually, when you look at it and you look at people like Yvonne Brewster, who, along with Carmen, along with Mona, started Talawa. Yvonne's just turned 80. She won't thank me for saying that. You know, but, you know, that is the sort of stuff. Those people who paved the way.
Yeah.
But I would also say that the staying power of people like Sicily, the people who are in the backgrounds, maybe not the big stars, but they're there and they're doing the stuff and they're slowly collecting all these awards and things. When I look at, let's just look at Adjoa. Yeah.
Yeah.
doing work over and over and over. Okay, you take Bridgerton, you take Doctor Who, you take Casualty, you take, you know, Invictus.
Yeah,
all these are out there doing the work over and over at a high level, You know, if you look at Noma, you know, Noma is now in the States doing. People don't realize Noma has a Tony. Noma has two Olivier Awards. You know,
yeah. So there'll be people listening to this, right?
Yeah,
who think that we're going off into a world. But I would just suggest to those people before we move on that these are people and these are names that we suggest that you look up because you might be surprised at what they've done that you actually know. Oftentimes when people are famous, you look back at a film or a play that you saw years ago and you didn't even realize that they were in it. I've got one of those youngsters coming on, young compared to everybody here anyway, coming on in a little while. Before we do that, I want to go to the boss lady. Boss lady is here. How are you, boss lady?
Hello, I'm fine. Hello, Cyril. Hello, Adjua. Lovely to see you. Hello, Curtis. Hello, Eddie.
Hello, boss lady.
Hello. They're loving the two actors, actresses that you've got on today. Cyril, they loved you in the Bill, and they're calling you Adjua, the Britain Queen. And you look stunning with your hairstyle. All the comments are saying that they love the program. They're saying it's a lovely, diverse cast. And they loved the storyline. It took them out of lockdown, which is what I think you were saying, Adjua, White was doing so well. They loved the fashion. They loved you. And they wanted to know when series two was coming out.
Well, COVID allowing, we start shooting again in April. So, I don't know, end of the year? I'm making that up. I've not heard it. Yeah,
they can't wait for it. They can't wait for it.
Oh, that's
and
great.
Also, talking about, they said an absolute legend. She rest in peace, Cicely Tyson, a true icon, a beautiful lady, a fab actress. So loads of messages coming towards for her. May she rest in peace. And just big up to the sponsors again, to the big man Andy McCall. A design and engineering company for the private sector, the beautiful Alison Delaney, a Standard Gold company, helping individuals achieve their full attention potential, and to the legendary mastermind, he will be doing his live show today between 4 to 7. Here's just a quick clip of what he will be doing.
www.thelegendarymastermind.com for uninterrupted streams. Remember, every Sunday, 4 to 7. We all running the same race, just in case. Spread the word. Share the link. Monsters in their face. The people who just like to have good vibes. Money made, bills to be paid. Like, remember, check out the website in the week as well. Look, all the information's on there. But baby, as I said, the Lafayette products coming soon.
So that's Lewis.
It'll be on today, 4 to 7. Look. Keep the comments coming in. Don't forget to like, hashtag, and share. See you later on. Bye bye.
See you later, bus lady. Love you.
Bye. Sorry, Eddie, you've drawn everybody's attention to my eyebrows. Lockdown is here. I can't get it done. I just have to make do. Sorry. I'll talk to him afterwards.
Doesn't matter what anybody says. I think they look lovely.
Yeah, right. Okay. Bye bye.
Curtis, I've never liked you. It's important that you know that. Right, so listen, I've got this long list of stuff that I had planned to do. It's all here, all these really important subjects. Because I've got three troublesome people here. We have done absolutely nothing. And we're going to continue to do absolutely nothing. Except to look, I was going to call him the future, but I think he's the present, actually. Take a look at this young man in the latest the first one I know of anyway. Two black guys with guns, but they're the cops. Take a little look at this.
The
kidnapped girl is headline news.
We'll be assisted by our British colleagues, but they'll be observing only.
You say, man. What are you gonna do?
Start playing by the rules. This is not London.
All right, Uncle Phil, cool down, man.
Tell me where the missing girl is.
Come on holiday, Bishop. You'll be relaxing, you said.
Go, go!
This ain't relaxing.
Whoa, hold on, you invited yourself.
You bought that on yourself! Ladies and gentlemen, big up Asher D, also known as Ashley Walters. Greetings, Ashley.
How you doing, guys? You alright?
Hey, Ashley.
Yeah,
hey,
you really, So, you know everybody here, or who do you know?
I know everyone there. I know every single one of you, man. You guys are my, I wouldn't say my elders because I don't want to be rude, but you know, I've worked with Curtis, I've worked with Cyril, I've worked with Adjoa, and obviously, you know, I know you, Eddie. So yeah, man, you're all kind of, you're up there to me, man. I heard you guys talking about legends and stuff like that, but guys, you know, you have all inspired me in different ways throughout my career. I've taken some really great advice from you guys, even if you didn't know it. So I appreciate you all.
So one of the things, and thanks for coming on. Thanks to Uncle Robbie for setting it up for us.
Who wrote that speech for you, by the way?
It was good, wasn't it?
It was good. Did I email that to you?
No. Honestly, first time I spoke to him was this morning. We've done it all virtually. I don't know about the others, but I feel when I watch you like I've watched a boy become a man. Does that make sense to you, Ashley?
Yeah, 100%. I mean, I've grown up on screen, really. That's the reality of it. I've grown up on screen and you know, Cyril will know, especially like, you know, I spent a lot, you know, it's taken me a long time to get to that man stage. You know, I've at some points not really taken my career seriously and taking it for granted the opportunities that I've had. But very clearly, like for me, the whole journey has been a great lesson, you know, and where I am now, 38 years old, 8 children, married nearly 8 years this year.
Wow.
Do you know what I mean?
And a granddad.
And a granddad as well, yeah. So I shouldn't forget my granddaughter. Yeah, I mean, yeah, the lessons have been learned, you know, and I'm in a beautiful space right now, a beautiful place mentally. Do you know what I mean? Mentally in my own head, regardless what's going on in the outside, I'm enjoying it now, what I'm doing. I'm really enjoying it. I'm really present in it. So that's a good thing for me.
It is a good thing. And I mean, I'm watching you. I told you I watch you with Freddie. And certainly that journey to being in a good space is a challenging and interesting one. I want to go back because I'm not sure that, you know, council estate kids are supposed to be big time actors and the like. So we'll find it. Let's start. I messaged you a few months ago. I saw a video of you and you mentioned the word mentally. And so if it's all right with you, I'd like to make that journey because it is something that I think will be of interest to not just the panel, but everybody looking at. You were in a place, you know, and apart from seeing your queen hug you in the way that anybody would want their queen to hug them. Tell me about that journey from that moment to now, Ashley.
The reality is my life has been, I've been very lucky and gifted in the sense that I've worked consistently, you know, I've always had work and that doesn't happen for everyone. And lockdown came, that was a huge shock to me. I don't know how everyone else dealt with it, but for me, that took my head somewhere else. Do you know what I mean? The fact that I couldn't do what I do, and I couldn't hide in it anymore. You know, a lot of us, we don't want to be ourselves. You know what I mean? We find it difficult to live with ourselves. So my way of getting out of that was performing. My way of that was pretending to be someone else every day. And that was taken away from me in one fell swoop. And I found it really difficult. I had a lack of routine, you know, I drank a bit too much. I did things that I wasn't meant to be doing throughout that time. And feelings that I was kind of probably hiding from and numbed from, I had to deal with, you know. And there was a moment where I really felt that the Black community didn't feel that I had contributed to the space that I was in, and that actually that I wasn't behind the whole Black Lives Matter concept and movement. And, you know, and this is why social media can be a dangerous thing, because
yeah.
I had time to listen and to read comments that were being given. Do you know what I mean? I had time to go into that. And it put me in a bad headspace, man. You know, I really felt like, you know, the actual thing I was trying to do was to address that. But the emotions just came to the surface. Do you know what I mean? I was addressing the fact that I really felt that, you know, behind the scenes, what I've been doing personally was always about, I know you're talking about Cicely Tyson and like, that for me, it was always about every role that I was taking was never just about money or my own advancement. It was about what is going to happen for the person coming behind me. Do you know what I'm saying? What happens for the next generation? What happens for the next guy that's trying to be in this position? Because as you guys will know, it's a battle. Whether you see me on these big shows or whatever or not, to get there is a battle. It's a battle more for us than it is for our white counterparts. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So I really felt like, you know, I'd been breaking down doors and breaking down barriers and whatever. And it just felt like some people didn't agree with that. Some people felt that I was on the other side. Do you know what I mean?
But what did you do with that? Because everybody's nodding their head. Everybody did that. The one thing about lockdown is it's made us all, which is why probably me and Curtis are doing this.
Very true.
Is part of our therapy, right? But what did you do with that? Because you've got to look at it and you've got to put it out, Ashley. You've got to decide, right, this is a moment I'm going to put out. And then you've got to deal with what you've uncovered. So talk to me about that.
Listen, a lot of therapy, a lot of meditation, a lot of prayer, finding faith in something else that is bigger than me. Because for many years, I thought I was the creator. I thought I was the one running this. Do you know what I'm saying? And the fact of the matter is, I am not. Do you know what I mean? There is a power higher than myself that has watched over me for many, many years, even if I didn't want to admit it. At some points, and now I do, and you know the fact that I can put my faith in a higher power that is not myself gives me the opportunity to focus on the things that I need to focus on. Do you get what I'm saying? And having that spiritual connection has changed my life. You know, it's just changed my life. I've spoken to Cyril about this, and when me and Cyril were working together way back when at Royal Court, I know, you know, he wanted to help me a lot of the time. I think he was looking at me, you know, like, and tried to have many conversations with me, but I was reluctant to accept things that older people were saying to me. Do you know what I'm saying? Because I felt I knew everything. But
that's why we love you, because we were looking at you thinking you were going to be... All of us were looking at you thinking you're going to be Tupac.
Really?
Yeah, because you've got so much talent. You got that thing that they say in the old films. They say you got to do the Montgomery Clift thing. When you walk onto screen, you got to look like there's a secret. There's something going on, and that's how you look all the time. And I thought that it looked like that because you got the devil in you, probably.
Yeah, probably at that point. It's no joke, man. It's no joke. You know, there were some dark times for me, man. And I'm just like, you know, I'd say to anyone listening that needs to hear this information, you know. Dealing with your life trauma, you know, and your past and stuff like that is the most important thing for moving forward. You don't want to dwell on it. Do you know what I mean? And you don't want to, you know, live in that past. But getting it out there, dealing with it, you know, and moving forward and not too living too far in your future just gives you the ability to focus on today. And that's what I do. It's one day at a time for me, man. It's like, If I don't do that, if I don't focus on today, this hour, the minutes I'm talking to you guys now, and I'm thinking about what I want and what I want to get too much or what happened before, I'm in a bad place. I'm in problems. So that's been the change. That's been the basic change for me. It sounds simple, but it can be difficult to get yourself there. And it took me a while to understand it.
So one of the
the beauty. Sorry, I think that's the beauty of this aspect of lockdown, because I was in the park watching your video and it shook.
Oh, we lost Curtis.
Oh, we lost Curtis.
Right.
I'm gonna let me pick up that just a bit, because actually, when did we work? It was about, gosh, 2008 or something. I can't remember.
Yeah, something like that.
Young Vic, yeah. And I, you know, when I saw the video, I just felt like it was like my son, and I wanted to scoop you up, because you know, you've been working for a long time when I worked with you, but you're so talented, and you're such a generous actor on stage to work with, and as a man, you have a sweetness about you that I want all our, you know, all our sons and our nephews and our boys coming up to see your sweetness and to see your talent and your absolute smart, kind, generous gifts that you have, and to really absorb them. So yes, when that video came out, it's like that's the sweetness of a human being just being open, and it's a beautiful. I know that it was a distress for you, but it's a beautiful generosity and good energy that I think you put out in the world, and it's a thing that's a good model, and I'm so glad to know you and glad you're working and glad that you're shining, because you know you're someone else's shoulders to come on now. You know, you look at us like a bunch of old kids, which indeed we are. But you know, you're someone else's shoulders now, and it's good shoulders.
Also about vulnerability as well. Sometimes as men, we're not allowed to show our vulnerability, especially, I imagine, parts of the world that actually exist in, and his friends and his so on. That vulnerability is so crucial. And that's unfortunately, we learn that too late in life, that being that's vulnerable is nothing wrong with that, you know?
I just want to add, you know, when I saw that video, it really shook me up, but it also made me, you know, realize, and I think working with you all that time ago, Ash, you know, one of the joys of having somebody who has been given this talent, you know, who's been given this, is also that you realize that there is that vulnerability there. The why people love you, why people, you know, can get in there, is because there is a vulnerability there. There is a way of, you know, we're all in this arts thing, and it's about sharing that catharsis, allowing people to come into your life so that they can see, you know, part of their own lives.
Yes.
And that is the joy of that and the raw talent of that. But at the same point, you know, and all those years ago, you've got to realize that actually it's part of a journey. And that's why I always think it's really important. Like earlier on, you know, I was saying, no, George Harris was the person, you know. Actually, before them, there were others. Before them, you know, when we were doing Julius Caesar in New York, I started a little film club with some of the younger guys. Now, you know, it's an all-black cast, all these young guys, taking them through some of those films. Because some people commented, like, you know, Babylon, like, you know, all those films which were done in the 70s, you know, saying, actually, this has been done before. You know, this is it. We've got to realize we're just part of a journey. And, you know, the Rudolphs, the Normans, you know, those people stood up and did that stuff. And their vulnerability allowed me to walk off and do it myself. And hopefully everyone will come after. And as you don't know how important it is that you are there, that vulnerability is there, that you can be able to tap into that, but that is hard to take on one's own. The public sphere is all very well, but the internal sphere, we have to take care of that. And like Adjoa said, you know, there are points when you just want to just hold somebody and say, it's all right, it's all right, it's all right to be there, because there's a lot of weight on those shoulders, you know, and people don't realize it. So I think it's fantastic, and the journey you're making, you know, will only enhance, will only allow that to get better, you know, and keep grabbing it. I love, you know, the people coming up.
And we're all here going like that.
Yeah.
Well, not at the time when I watched it, I wasn't going like that. Tell me about, because you come from a different world, you know, and that grime world for a time, I think you got something at the back of your head that shows it, that you know, was a completely different world. To actually go into therapy at all, was that a difficult thing to do?
Not at the place I was. I needed it. Listen, like I think, kind of alluding to what Cyril was saying and Adjoa, the people that are on my shoulders, really, it's not just, you know, the industry. It's not just other actors coming up. It's my kids. It's my family. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, you got a lot of that money. Yeah,
yeah, exactly. So it was, for me, it was more about, I was at a stage where, you know, I actually couldn't help anyone in my family anymore. Do you know what I'm saying? And that meant, you know, I couldn't be a parent. I couldn't be a dad. I couldn't father my boys and teach them right from wrong because of the place where I was mentally. You know, I was shying away from that on a daily basis and using my job as a place to hide. So for me, it was desperation that took me to where I needed to go. And maybe that's too late. You know, maybe I should have seen it before, but the fact of the matter is it happened that way, you know, and it's been I'll keep on saying, it's been the best thing. You know, there's a, like Curtis was saying, there's a huge thing in where I come from about being a man, and to everyone there, being a man is not crying, you know, not showing your emotion, not sharing your problems or whatever. But for me, you know, that was the only way. It was the only way forward. And I quickly realized that there's a huge difference between, you know, humility and humiliation. Do you know what I'm saying? You know, the fact that people, you know, it's a strength. It's a strength to be able to share your problem. Do you know what I'm saying? It's a strength. Because it's such a difficult thing to do, but it's a strength to share your problem, and you only get power from it. Do you know what I'm saying? And I've realized that, and it's something that I have to do now. I have to be completely honest with it. And you know, a lot of people won't like it. You know, a lot of people don't like it. I get a lot of people in my team are like, you know, they don't want you to say certain things in interviews and do this and do that or whatever. But I can't have it any other way, because actually, what I'm here for is not myself. I'm here for the other guy. Every day I'm here for the other guy. That's what this whole thing is about, and that's what's kept me here, you know, is being able to give what I've learned back to other people. And I can't do that without telling my story. I can't do it without being truthful about what my story is. So that's it in a nutshell.
No, and it's, you know, it's lovely to come on and be that honest. Yeah, sorry, Adra.
I think there's something really radical for us as Black people. You know, the default thing is to have used us as Black people through history is to go, you know, they can carry more, they don't feel as much. You know, whether you're talking about Black women dying in childbirth or whatever, you know, whatever it is, it's like we're supposed to be hard, tough, unfeeling, you can work them to death, all that sort of stuff. Do you know what I mean? And so for me, the radical thing to go, I'm simply a human being, and I have human weaknesses and strengths and vulnerabilities, and I'm allowed to own all of them, and that has nothing to do with the color of my skin. That's my soul.
But I think we do it to ourselves as well, Adjoa. I think, if I'm honest with you,
we tell ourselves we need to be X or Y. Sure. We all buy into it. But you know, the radical thing is the pushback that goes, I'm just me. I'm just me trying to get by. And I'm gonna own all of that, and I'm gonna articulate it, because that's actually true. That's the truth.
Yeah, right. but buying into it is a way of saying, you know, I need to survive. And we use various survival techniques, yeah.
Sometimes
they go too far. And then they start to damage us, yeah. And it's about being able to let those things go and saying they were appropriate for just survival.
Then,
but actually now, you know, especially, you know, what lockdown has done is it's given a pause. So people have to look at themselves.
But they don't always like what they
see. Yeah. There's a huge difference. The public sphere and the outer sphere, you know, the inner sphere and the outer sphere are two totally different things. I was talking to Timmy Akinbola, you know, and we were just greeting each other about, you know, and I said, yeah, you know, I hope that both on the public and the private level that you're doing all right in this stuff.
Because and what did he say?
Well, yeah, exactly. I mean, he was talking about, yeah, all these achievements and whatever else. That's great. But actually, on the inside, you've got to deal with the everyday. Yeah. The everyday and the stuff that really hurts. And some of those scars are long back in, you know, and we will repeat and repeat and repeat those childhood scars, you know.
Unless we face up to them.
Yeah,
I'm going to stop you again.
Yeah,
I'm going to stop you again. I promise I'm going to keep this show to an hour or near. Yeah. About, no. Everything that you're like the sage now, the wise old man. You know what I mean? we hang on your every word. I please forgive me. I don't mean to do that. I you just
know. The white beard there calling me all of the time.
And it takes 10 minutes to tell you we're trying to hurry the show up.
I know.
you got issues with me, Curtis. And when this is over, I'm going to buy you some Jack Daniels. A year ago today, I had an event with 800 people in a space. It was a black event with a space that should really have only had 300 people. And Curtis turned up. The whole bottle of Jack Daniels was gone. So a year ago today. Ashley, listen. We've got 8 minutes and I want to get 5 things in, right? But I'm going to start with... How much, right? Because we ain't even talked about, and we're not going to get a chance to talk about football or any of the others today. But how much did go in? So I found this picture. you knew I was going to go there at some point because you're an Arsenal supporter. I support Man United. So me and you can never be friends like that. Manchester. We've talked about them. Shut up, sir. We've talked about the mental side. How much does the physical side feed into that?
Yeah, physical. Oh, gosh. It's been a huge thing. I mean, that first started out of me just not liking how I looked. Kind of one day, Noel and I were watching the monitor back after we'd done a take. I saw like 4 rolls on the back of his neck. You know what I mean? And then my stomach was sticking out there when I turned sideways. And we were like, we have to do something about this. You know what I mean? Otherwise, we are not competing anymore. Do you know what I'm saying? So literally the next day, we both got personal trainers. We both started some new nutritious diet or whatever. And we decided to...
Should we have a look at the result? Should we have a look to see if it...
That's not the result.
That is about 12, dear. I'm about 12 in that one. That was before.
There you go.
Is that what you're working with now?
That's what. Well, yeah. I put on a few. I put on a few. Don't worry about it.
Where's mine, Eddie? Do mine now, Eddie. Do mine now. What's up with
you? There's not enough steam, Curtis. There's not enough steam.
How much work does that take?
Every day, day in, day out, watching what you eat. I think the hardest part to explain to people is that you have to change your eating habits. That's the only way that you're going to change your body in that sense, or in a short period of time. It's all about the eating. I was eating too much sugars, too much foods that just didn't agree with my body. You know, I worked out throughout this whole period. I'm lactose intolerant. I've got a gluten intolerance, things like that that were bloating me and whatever, and dealing with my body wrong. So I just had to change the way I eat and watch what I eat. I calorie count every day now, man. I literally have an app. I put everything that I eat into it, and you can pretty much eat what you want, except the things that you have an allergy to or whatever. But you just make sure that you eat a certain amount a day. And I train on a daily basis, however big, you know, long or short. I make sure I train. I jog every morning. I wake up 5:30 every morning. I jog, come home, meditate, pray. Do you know what I mean? And I do a little home workout, and I get on with my day, and that keeps it at bay. Listen, I'm 38 now. When I turned 30 years old, I realized that there was no more slouching. You know what I mean? It doesn't work like that anymore. The metabolism went to a different place. And I realized I have to work. I work for it if I want it. So that was it.
You were talking about when you get to 30. Ask Cyril about what happens when you get to 60.
I'll let you know.
Right, boss lady, what you got? Can we get the boss lady back on? What you got for us, boss lady?
Hello, Ashley. They love you out there. The comments are just flying in. Hello, you okay? They love you. What they're saying is they respect. Sorry. They respect your transparency. They're loving your attitude to gratitude. Pauline says there are those who don't know what you've had to overcome to be where you are today, and you spoke your truth. Many are saying social media can be very toxic. Andy's saying you're a true inspiration. Hazel Barnes says believe in yourself is the greatest gift. Caroline says it takes courage to put yourself out there, at Ashley. Onwards and upwards. You are who they will be calling legend in years to come. And Darren Week says, love the honesty, gives us all men hope that speaking up helps us to be stronger. And that's what you were saying, Curtis, how men feel uncomfortable about making themselves feel vulnerable. And hearing your truth today, Ashley, I think has inspired people to speak up. And Eddie, Stella's saying, the cast is fantastic today. Thank you.
They're all bloody lovies today. Boss, I'm going to come back to you in a minute. Let's do one quick one. What are we going to do? Because I had all these incredibly serious things. We're not going to do any of that. Let me start with the argument I'm having with in my house. Right. Don't muck about you guys. Ashley, banana cake or carrot cake?
Carrot cake.
Adjoa.
Oh, I like them both. I'm going banana.
Curtis,
I'm going carrot.
And Cyril,
carrot every time.
Yes, Cyril, it's all of you. I'm the banana. Boss lady is the carrot. You're gonna cause me problem in my house when this thing is done today.
I'm banana.
Well, and that's why you are my wife. Let's do this last one. I saw this guy, right, and I did think, this is such a talented guy. And I just thought, I wondered if any of us had ever applied any in any of the roles that we've done. So, boss lady, play our final video of the day for me, please. That normally means she doesn't know which video I'm talking about. The accents. I'd like the video with the accents, please.
So I speak the English language because not only is it one of my native tongues, but it was the language used to colonize my ancestors. I do know that TikTok doesn't like when black people speak like this and prefer us to just entertain. But anyway, that's why I speak the English language. Español. Me gusta el español porque el español me da un sentimiento de pasión, de poesía, como lo de Gabriel García Márquez. Entonces, le français, je parle français quand je voudrais être en personne de diplomatie, en personne romantique, intéressant, parce que le français a quelque chose, le je ne sais quoi. Alors, chaque style Tokyo a Nihongo Hanas Desne. Nihongo Miasa, Nihongo Wakaru? Wakaru yo? So deska, so des yo ne. But in time, I have to cross off people, me have to talk in a patwa, because I can't tell people what them ras in the other language. So, in time, I have to cross you off, me have to cross you off in a patwa. Thank you.
I'm fairly certain, Cyril, you could speak another language.
Can I?
Can you? Can you do a language or an accent? Tell me one that you've gone for and you've had to put a language or an accent on.
No. I really don't speak any Igbo. I speak a tiny, tiny bit of Igbo, you know, and the tiniest bit of French. But I really couldn't get by, you know. I won't starve, but then, you know. But I'm not gonna get by in any other language, really.
Curtis, you could barely speak English. What you got?
I speak about four languages, Eddie, and I've travelled the world. And let me tell you, I'll always eat.
Yes, right. Adjoa, can you do another language?
Ich kann ein bisschen Deutsch sprechen, je peux parler un peu français. But can I speak Fanti, my own tribal language? Can I heck? I'm so embarrassed. I go to Ghana and they look at me.
What did you say? Somebody's phoned. Did you just cuss in another language?
No, that's actually getting work.
Oh, work. No, okay. No. I haven't heard my phone for months.
It was my front door. Sorry, guys.
She's getting another job. It come like that, the rest of it. I can't. I'm busy.
I mean, you're cut.
So can you do the accents or the whatever? Didn't you do it in Get Rich or Die Trying?
Yeah,
to do the American accent. Yeah, how was that?
It was Jamaican. I had to do in that eventually in the end. But yeah, that was cool, man.
Because you tried everything else, and they said,
"Yeah."
What did you say, man?
Curtis, you're actually right. That's what actually happened.
Yeah.
I went there, and it was meant to be an American actor for the character. And the producer came to me and was like, "Boy, I don't think this is gonna work." So that's how that happened. And the weirdest thing about it is I got cussed by all my family for that because they said your Jamaican accent was terrible.
But they don't know.
they don't know. Listen, guys. Ashley, thanks for coming on this thing, man. I really appreciate it. It's, for me, it's important that always to stay connected. I saw you on with ZZ as well. I saw you on, as I said, with Freddie. So clearly, you're still connected. And, you know, we're all rooting for you, man. Because we don't talk, you got to know everybody saw the video and everybody's got your back. So, you know, you got this, yeah?
And
so
don't answer the door, Ashley. It might be Robbie G. Don't answer the door. He's been doing this. Listen, every time we're interviewing people, he run around the yard and ring bell. Don't answer the door.
He's desperate to get on, man. He wants to get on. That's
We don't want it, Ash. We don't want it. Ed, I could do it, you know. I could do it now. We're nice. We're cool. God bless you, Ash. Take it easy. Look after yourself. Yeah? Thank you so much.
Well done, brother.
Thank you.
Lovely.
Adjoa, I forgot to say thank you very much to Netflix for allowing us to play that clip. So let me say that now in case the publicist gets that right. Thank you very much, Netflix. How are you feeling about what you're going to do? Because I've seen you a lot more. It seems to me you're a lot more vocal. You're a lot more out there now. Is that on purpose?
Yeah. Yeah. I bump into Curtis walking the dogs. So at one level, you know, I'm still picking up crap in the garden and doing the washing and telling the kids to get up and all the things that we're doing. And that's like just life chugging along. But you know, I'm a fair trade patron and there's things I want to talk about in the world. And if I'm doing this Netflix thing and I can, then I will, because what's that feels like important.
Well,
you know, I've
important.
Always been a bit like this. So
gob on a stick.
Power to you, babe. Power to you, sister.
Thank you very much. Love you, babe. Thanks for doing it for us. I appreciate it very much.
Pleasure.
Look after yourself. Stay safe.
Yeah,
God bless you.
That's
thank
it,
you very
much.
Yeah.
Sage, Cyril, a wise one. How are you?
Wise. Eddie, thank you for this.
It is 60 in April, isn't it? If
it's 60 in April, yeah. You know, and then I can apply for my bus pass before they take it away.
Oh, no, you won't get that. That's going to go, I'm afraid.
I know.
I can go anywhere I want. I have my freedom pass. I don't need you. So, yeah, that's lovely. Listen, mate, thanks for coming on. You know I'm going to bother you again. I really do appreciate it. Please stay safe.
Thank you.
I mean, it's the directing I'm really waiting for, mate. So, you know, when you're ready. Come, because I think that you got a special talent for that.
I promised you a part years and years ago on the Lonely Londoners.
and what happened there? Now, look, go, because we want to keep it polite. God bless you. Take it easy. Bye. God bless you. Boss lady.
Hello, all these
things I've written down. We were going to do the vaccine because I'm on a panel this week. We were going to do 100,000. It was an awful week with 100,000 dead. We were going to do Black Lives Matter nominated for a Nobel Peace Prize. And none of that.
It just goes to show how amazing your cast was people loved them. They loved Ashley's honesty. They love Cyril and they love Adjoa. You know, Bridgerton is on now. That's what they wanted to hear about.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly. And I've got a feeling the vaccine will still be a story next week. Just something
and
else.
A few more weeks.
Yeah. Just tell us something about that. I don't know.
I think so. I think sometimes you've got to go with the flow. Listen, mate, God bless you. Thank you very much, Boss Lady. Did you get all your comments?
Sorry. I just wanted to say banana cake won, okay?
No, it didn't.
No, carrot cake. Banana cake. I'm just going to do a little plug. If you want to make banana cake,
where do I go?
On Instagram, and you can find the recipe. It's really simple, vegan banana cake. You'll enjoy it. It's right there. Thank you, Eddie. Thank you, Ted. Thank you to everyone that's listening. Well done
for your appearance on Quincy's Extra Time Friday. Well done.
Thank you. Did you like it? Thank you. Have a good weekend, everybody.
I like the program. I don't like you and they're talking about me, but anyway, sorry. Thank you very much, Boss Lady.
Bye-bye. Have a lovely weekend. Bye, Curtis. Bye-bye.
Bye, Boss Lady.
How you doing, Curtis? All right for you?
I'm good, my brother. That was lovely, yeah.
Yeah,
apart
I mean...
from you lot loving, lovely, fest. But no, it was nice. Till Ashley came on and then it got nice again, you know what
I'm
mean?
Seeing you in more and more things on telly. So I think you carry on there talking about fest. I think I've seen you more and more.
Oh, lovely, darling, lovely. I remember when I worked with you. I believe it was Taming of the Shrew. Wasn't it, Eddie? Taming of the Shrew? No, it was brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. And I see Adjoa quite regularly out in the park, you know?
What is this thing with you? Of course you don't. Your dog looks like it would eat people. Why would anybody talk to you with that monster?
Or maybe it's that. But I'll send him over to her to say hello, and she just runs off screaming. So I don't know what that's about.
That's right. Listen, mate, we were supposed to
have
Solomon on.
Have you watched Bridgerton? I meant to ask you, but I waited till she's gone. Have you watched it, Eddie?
I haven't watched Top Boy, Bulletproof, or Bridgerton. I've got this thing with Tell It in a Minute. I start watching a program and it ends up watching me.
That's it, man. It's old age because people are telling me, oh, you've got to watch this. And I haven't watched it yet. I tried to watch it last night and I just fell asleep, man.
No, but you're not going to watch the whole thing. It's a series. It's not like, you know what I mean? It's fantastic, you know?
It's fantastic. And the soundtrack on it is awesome because they're doing old-style violin. But if you listen to the music, it's modern music. Very interesting the way they've done it.
Yeah, I just want to look at it because apparently it's got good sex scenes.
Yeah, you would really fancy the lead guy.
Everybody else does. So why would I be any different? Curtis, God bless you, my brother. I'll see you next week. Listen, thanks to everybody. If Life Spear, absolutely. Listen, thanks to everybody for watching. Truly appreciate your support. You can watch previous episodes. You can buy a T-shirt. You can buy a mask even. We need your support. We keep it going. We do our best to get casts to do different types of shows every week. If there's a subject that you think that we should be doing that we haven't perhaps done yet, then please find me. Apparently I'm the easiest person in the world to find. Let me know. We'll do our best to put it on for you. This Wednesday I've got a day off work. I'm doing a debate for Westminster Council. It's Lord Simon Woolley, Professor Kevin Fenton, who's lead for public health in England, Dr. Sonia Adesira, and me. I don't quite know why I'm on there, except maybe to put your point of view. Less than 50% of black people over the age of 80 are taking the vaccine. A number of people I speak to are really, really uncertain. They don't want to take it. And yet black people are dying at 2 or 3 times the rate as white people. What is the truth about the vaccine? And we're going to try and find out. You can join me, all platforms available at 6:30 on Wednesday. I'd love to have you there because I am going to be there speaking, I hope, on your behalf. So thanks from the whole team. God bless you and I. Hope nothing but good things happen for you this week. Take care.
Gratitude, graciousness, and grit. three words which describe the fabric that is
Cicely Tyson.
As one of President Obama's last official acts of office, he awarded the 92 years young actress and activist the Presidential Medal of Freedom. And for good reason, because more than an award-winning actress, Cicely is a groundbreaking cultural luminary, paving the way for a generation who walk behind. Duly noted when she received a Kennedy Center honor in 2015.
I would not exist if it were not for Cicely Tyson. She has taught me so much about how to be who I am in this business and in this life.
After witnessing certain things, after experiencing certain things in my career, I realized that I could not afford the luxury of just being an actress. There were certain issues that I wanted to address, and I chose my career as my platform.